Let's go.
This is your radio, your station.
Welcome to Zone 10 Radio FM.
DJ, turn it up, 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 up.
The station where dance and R&B play together.
Hours of non-stop old school.
Check your systems are offline.
Number one for today's hits and all-time favorites. Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
Zone 10 Progressive Podcast.
Yes, 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 guys. Yes, it's Nicholas Slavani, aka Uncle Nick. Yes, you are listening to Zone 10 Progressive Podcast, brought to you by Zone 10 Radio FM. Guess what, guys? I'm not alone. I'm hanging out with my boy, yeah. Lungzen B. Lungzen, how's it, man?
Yeah, man. Everything is great. Everything is great. You know, a lot of words were palavra disappoint. Yeah.
Okay, oh, palavra of office. Well, a little tardy, a gum, a cush line, gum, get on a gamma cushion.
Ah, gamma cushion of owner, son of push up, push and peel. Nothing much, and I've got a little salwell, a little jerry was in the yard, the barrel scaffold, a bill, the Livona jerry was in the yard.
All right, okay, guys, like, I overtones, and we have our special guest. Wow. Listen, so one up a machine come in. Go busy. We have our sister here, our modeler. She goes by the name of Diiva. So let me give her a platform to introduce herself, you know. So my sister, how you doing?
well, can say I'm good.
Yeah. Mm. Ah. So now we're good. We're doing good. You know, it's really an honor to have you today in our radio station or in our show, you know. On our show. So how do you feel? How do you feel having us today?
Well, I won't say much, but then I feel so much blessed. I feel because I was waiting.
Yeah.
Until now I got it, so this is amazing. I was waiting for so long to talk to the world, and then I got a chance, so I feel amazing.
Hey, I'm a shit as long. Yeah, hey, teta boy, I'm so teta vinjana. Yeah, I can't even kill all the new anto guy. I'm so teta vinjana. Okay. So, my sister, can you tell us more about yourself? Please tell our listeners about yourself.
Well, I will start by introducing myself.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I go by the name of Okay Manaji, but then mostly know me as PHB Diivah. That's my stage name. So, I will do a little introduction that mostly models do. So, as you can hear that I'm here to talk to the world.
Yes.
So I go with the motto that I live by every day. Mm-hmm. And that motto makes me feel more special about modeling.
Yes.
Well, modeling is not just to impress someone.
Yeah.
But then it's doing something that is in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
And mostly using confidence, smile, walks, a lot of things.
Mm.
Well, most people can ask themselves why ladies choose to do modeling.
Mm.
Well, for my introduction, I can say modeling is when you are ready to face the world.
Yeah.
You are ready to face any challenges in the way and stand up for the world. I can say that's my introduction.
Wow. Mm. So you are a modeler.
Yeah.
Our African queen. Yeah. Okay. We hear you. Hey. Mr. Chakalaka. Yeah, I've been carrying a little over route to come studio. You know, hey, guy, some. It's a man of my sports, Nakwal. Yes. Anyway, guys, yeah, we are podcasting to you from Namahale, Fourscore Community Center. So, my sister, can you tell us what encouraged you, you know, to do modeling? What encouraged you?
Well, to be honest, a lack of confidence encouraged me. Because I grew up lacking confidence so much. And seeing people model and seeing people have confidence just made me realize that having confidence as a lady is very important. Well, as most people know, most girls, they don't know, they don't have confidence. Well, you will ask yourself, why do most ladies lack of confidence? Well, I can say it's because of rumors that they hear about themselves. Because people talk a lot outside. Whether they talk bad about you, you are ugly, you are shapeless, well, that doesn't mean anything for me. So that's the thing that made me become a model. And I realized mostly things that I saw like on TV. For example, I saw a beautiful lady being Miss Universe. Wow, she's dark and she's beautiful. That's the main thing that made me realize that modeling, anyone can be a model and anyone can have confidence. That way I started become having confidence. So, yeah.
Hey, sis man. What a good sis man. Yeah. I'm sure. About the girl. So, like, you come a very long way, like, with this thing. So, I think, like, we have a lot of experience.
Exactly.
So, can you please advise those young stars? You know, like in our community, like we have those youngsters, like those who dream to be modelers, you know? But they don't know perfect people to approach, you know, to help them fulfill that talent and stuff. So, how can you advise them?
Well, my advice for youngsters in our community will be like, don't allow self-esteem go down into yourself. Well, self-esteem is the very important thing that you should have as a youngster. Because, firstly, you will face many challenges in the way. And those challenges will be hard. For example, in me, becoming a mother wasn't an easy journey. But then, I told myself that I'm gonna be a strong lady as I am today. If I wasn't strong enough, I wasn't gonna be a model by today. I told myself that I'm going to quit modeling because of those challenges I was facing back then. But then here I am today. I'm the biggest model that many people wish to be me. And that thing makes me become more and more and more a model.
That's what's up.
So my advice for youngsters is, if you have a talent or a skill that you wanna experience, just go for it. Don't wait for people to judge you or expire you that that kind of a particular thing is a bad thing to do because you're gonna face a lot of challenges. Well, yes, each and every journey has challenges, but then as for you, you must do what you want. You must do what your heart tells you. And you must do what you are good at. Don't wait for someone to tell you that you must do it. But then you have to stand up for yourself and then become the thing that you want to be. And so that you can have a better future and a better success.
Wow. It seems like my boy here, like he has a question.
Yeah, I'm a tunkala for mood. Yeah, I'm a little bit of a little.
Yeah,
lo hustler a hustler ka sikhuwa mina sidile ka sigebe mina a road with silo mina yihayi. Okay ish question yeke na leona kiyona divor like mo do is introduce a village or go na man but then our roger ogwa we guy and ukumane aga.
Well, that my mistake that I did by then. Well, I can say, well, my home, I'm from KZN.
Okay.
By then, I grew up in Palaboranama. So during two school things, I moved to Joburg. That's where I started doing modeling. I started doing modeling in 2020 in Johannesburg until now. By then, I moved back here home in Palabora where I grew up. So if you want to find me, well, you can get me on WhatsApp on 079-198-6420. Oh, you can search me on Facebook. I go by the name of Koki PHB Diva with double I and H at the end.
Okay.
Well, if you wanna find me where I stay, you can come. You are available anytime. I'm also available. Well, you can text me on WhatsApp, same number, and ask for direction. As long as you are at Chelangape Garage, you will find me where I stay. That's my location.
Okay. All right.
You know,
I wish you guys could see what I'm seeing. Okay, have you came across challenges when it comes to modeling? And what solutions did you find to solve those challenges?
Well, I did face a lot of challenges in my modeling industry. And those challenges were not easy. They were hard to the point that I was giving up to myself. I was giving up telling myself that I'm no longer doing modeling because it's not easy journey for a lady. Well, those challenges, I would like to mention them because most girls are facing, but then they don't talk. Firstly, the challenge that I went to is I met another photographer. So the photographer told him, introduce me to an agency. So I joined the agency. When I joined the agency, only to find out that the agency was a woman trafficking. But then I didn't know. So we went there and do everything that they asked us to do. But then at the end, only to find out that that agency is a woman trafficking. And then I managed to escape that human trafficking. All thanks to my dad and my mom. Well, that challenge made me cry alone all day long, telling myself that I'm no longer doing modeling because it's a risk for a lady. Hearing people around when you go, hearing rumors, many rumors that are saying, you are selling your body, modeling is just selling your body to old men and stuff, wasn't easy for me because it also decreases my self-esteem. But then for my parents to be there, they told me that you have to stand up for yourself. I faced those challenges because of my parents. Every agency that I joined, my mom and my dad, they will always be there for me. They are working, yes, but then they will take a leave just because of me. Just because of they see how potential I am in modeling. How hungry I am to become the biggest model in the world. That's how I faced my challenge. Even today, I have many challenges I faced, but then they are still there for me. So any challenge that I'm going to face in the future, I'm ready for it. As long as my parents are here by my side, then I'm good.
So the L'Oreal challenge you are in the future, you are ready for them. So, can I question or what the goal is you get a fee on your own or achieve lane.
Well, I have many goals that I wanna achieve, but then the best goal that I wanna achieve is becoming a biggest model in the world. But then not the biggest model in the world, but the biggest lady in the world that will love to help old people, as old people are excluded. Yes. Well, I'm saying that because in our calendars, as we all know, we have Youth Day, Women's Rights, and like many things that involves women, men, and youth and youngsters. Like then, we don't have a day that combines old people just to thank them for being there for us. Why I say so? Because I grew up, well, without my mom. She was at school and working. But then, because of the love of my granny that she gave me, I'm here today because of her. So I would like to create a day whereby we combine old people just to thank them and do good things for them. Well, I would like to help the community. As the community these days, we got a lot of abuses. Women abuse, a lot of abuses. But then no one wants to stop that. As for me, I just want to become a biggest model in the world so that I can stop those things. So that our world can have peace, happiness, and love. That's my biggest goal.
Wow, you know what? Shout out to your mom, shout out to your dad.
Yeah, shout out to them.
Yeah, and your granny too. You know, granny is like their blessings, you know, from God. Yeah. As they usually take care of us, we also have to take care of them, you know. So, you mentioned your goals, like, Okada told you wanna achieve the goals here by the end of this year or by 5 years to come.
Oh, 5 years to come.
When? Oh. When would you like to achieve those goals?
5 years to come. We always way far.
Yeah.
This year. I can say.
Anytime soon.
Exactly. Anytime soon. But then, my plan was having, I've joined a lot of agencies this year. So, for my parents' support, for having them as my supporters and my fans also, will help me to win those competitions. And if I win those competitions, and then that's my goal. I can say by July, I can reach my goal.
July, you mean this year?
This year. Wow. I can reach the biggest goal that I wanted to reach.
Like after 3 months.
It's 3 months.
Yeah.
Wow.
Because I've joined a lot of agencies, and those agencies, the competition are being there for July. So after July, if I got the position of becoming the queen of Palabora and the queen of Lulekan, well, that's the biggest change that are going to happen in our township.
Okay. Yeah. Wow, man. Like, we are giving you all the blessings so that you can win, be the queen of Palabora, you know.
Yeah.
To give all the ladies who are in Palabora the impression, you know, that they can be what you are. According to you, you know, they say it like you dream big so that you can get to the top. Now you're the example for the young ladies who are around Palabora. We appreciate what you're doing, you know. Yeah,
that's what's up. So those are the only things that we are expecting from like that event in July or Ronaldo really expect how. Well, they're massive, yeah.
There are still more coming, especially the massive ones. Cause I was planning, after getting the positions that I've registered for July.
Mm.
Well, actually, my mom told me that I should join Miss Teen Universe.
Okay.
So, if I do that and I get the position, well.
Yeah.
That would be a big surprise that everyone wasn't expecting.
I believe you. I know you're gonna even murder them. 100% believe in you. You come a very long way. So I can't doubt that. Okay. All right. So, okay. You know, like I usually say this before I could sit down with a guest, you know, start questioning and stuff. If I could do that, I first stalk you.
Wow.
You know, I said this in our previous podcast, and I'm saying it again today. I want our guests to know this when they come. I stalk you, you know, like nobody's business, you know, so that I can have enough questions. You know? Okay, so I give you a chance to confess, you know, to confess some things. Okay, you only do modeling, or there are also some other talents that you know that you do that some people might not be aware. You know, today is your platform. Like you are not going to. Yes, you are not going to talk about modeling only. Like,
but you said you were stalking me. It means you know.
No, I want to give, I want to give you a chance to confess. Yes,
well,
yeah.
No, I'm not doing modeling only.
Okay.
Well, I can say my mom is proud for having me because I'm a blessing from God. Yeah. I got many talents.
Wow.
Like I'm very talented. I've got many talents that I'm doing.
Mm.
But then I'm only focusing on modeling because modeling I see that's the biggest talent that I'm approaching.
Mm.
Well, I'm also a sport player.
Okay.
I play sports. And when I'm talking about sports, I'm talking about a lot of sports.
Okay.
Well, I'm doing athletics.
Wow.
And as you know, under athletics, there's a short put, long jump, and also running and stuff. Yes, I'm doing all that because, with athletics, I was representing Mopani.
Mm.
I went to represent Mopani at Cape Town. That's where, I become the most.
Wow.
The most, the most biggest little lady that represent Mopani. I was the first one.
Eh.
Well,
mm.
I go to sports.
Mm.
Also representing Limpopo.
Wow.
In baseball, and I also did netball and ladies soccer. Well, don't be surprised, but I did play ladies soccer.
You know, I wonder why are you this fit?
I was doing ladies soccer and when I fit as well, I was the biggest striker.
Yes, man.
Yeah. And like my other talent is like I'm a poetry.
Yeah.
I write poems.
Okay.
And like those poems, like I express my feelings each and every single day.
Mm.
And like I'm also a singer.
Wow.
I can sing, but then I don't like it because it's those singing in the industry, like it's a challenge.
Nah, yo, but you can sing.
It's a lot of work. Yes, I can sing.
Yeah.
So that's the other challenges that I have.
Mm.
Yeah. And like, I won't say dancing because I can't dance. I can't dance.
Yeah, Shaw knows.
Dancing yourself by the money.
Yeah, I can't dance, Shemio.
Yeah,
but then
okay.
Just a diva with a sport player, singing poetry, and also modeling.
Multi-talented.
Yeah.
You know, I once came across to this post of yours on social media, you know. On your page. So you were talking about like anxiety, you know, motivating young girls, you know, like those kind of suicide things and stuff. You know, you were motivating them. There, you were talking about those things that they are not an option and stuff like that. So, can you please also, talk to our listeners about that? Let's say, like, there's someone who's suffering from anxiety or has those kind of suicide thoughts and stuff. Like, what can they do, you know, to get out from that kind of nightmare or that kind of situation? Because like from the way you wrote, like you know how to get out of that kind of situation and stuff. So what can they do?
Well, during to anxiety in society, the biggest challenge that a person are facing, and like that's the thing that mostly make us youth cry a lot. because we are losing our loved one because of society. Well, I can say I've been there.
Yeah.
I once have that mind thought of committing suicide, but then I sat down and told myself that no, this is not an option. I can create a society, and then, well, I'll just die and rest in peace. But yeah. Then my loved ones,
yeah,
my family, like, they will cry a lot because they once have a beautiful soul named Diiva. Well, crossing that, I managed to have peace in my life because I found a person that, like, a biggest person that I trusted in my whole life. That particular person, like, he was the one that I was talking to him about my problems.
Yes.
When I face suicide, like, when I face something that has anxiety inside and lead me to suicide, I was telling that particular person about my situation.
Yeah.
And, like, I was so glad to have that person because the friend of mine that I was having, well, he was a good friend. Actually, he is a good friend. I won't say he was, because, like, he's still my friend.
Yeah.
He is a good friend because, like, it was, like, he was advising me, like, a lot of things. How can I defeat those anxieties?
Yeah.
Well, for me, I defeated those things by singing. As you know, I can sing.
Okay.
I was just singing a lovely song.
Yeah.
And then I become down. And then I come down and then become myself again.
Yeah.
Or if I don't feel like singing, I was just wearing my sports outfit and go play some sports out there.
Yeah.
Or wearing my heels and I do modeling.
Like, you keep yourself busy.
I keep myself busy because sitting alone, it will make you think a lot. It'll make you think more.
Yeah.
That's why when you are a person, you must have friends around you.
Yeah.
So that you can avoid those things.
Yeah.
Well, my advice for the people that are facing those challenges is to have friends close to you. Don't be alone. Because when you're alone, you will think of doing something stupid. And that's not a solution. Because you will kill yourself, and then after, who gonna cry? Us. Because we love you. We thought you are the great person to have around. But then as you do something stupid, well, I can say it's stupid because, wow.
You're selfish.
Exactly. You are thinking about yourself.
Yeah.
Not thinking about others around you.
Yeah.
Well, society is not a solution at all. It's not a solution at all. Even though you were facing a biggest challenge, like, mostly girls, they face biggest challenge by getting raped and stuff. These are social workers. These are people that you can talk to.
Yeah.
But then you can go there. And those women out there, they won't publish your story just because of you will feel like they will publish. No, that's not a solution. You can go there and consult with them and then talk to them. They will help you get through to that anxiety. Even your friends, you must have a friend that you trust. Not many friends that will go gossip around your situations, but then a friend that will trust and give you advices and be there for you all the time that you need.
Yeah.
And even your parents, communication with the parents is needed. Most youngsters nowadays, they don't talk to their parents.
Yeah.
Me, I talk to my mother, especially my dad. My dad James, my super me. I always talk to him about a lot of things. Even girl stuff, I talk to my dad.
Wow, shout out to you.
Shout out to him.
Yeah.
I talk to my dad because I know he's the one that I'm close to. I feel like this one, I don't want to lose.
Yeah.
So, yeah, my advice is, like, suicide must stop to our community. Because, like, it's not a good thing at all. We are losing people each and every single day, every Saturday. Like, we are burying someone. And when you look at that someone, it's a youth. Our youth is kind of in pain. It's kind of in tears. Well, someone can say, why, God, do you do this? No, it's not God. But then it's our friends that are being selfish.
Yeah, yeah,
so I can say, having people around, kind of amazing.
Are you sure you're teaching me though? Since you say you are coming from you born in KZN and stuff, Josie, you know. Yeah. Okay, guys. So, I want to give you a platform. You know, in this world, like, you have to choose, or you want to sing for us, or you want to,
render us a poem, because like you told us two things, you know, that can be performed live. Yeah, even my technical producers back there, they are agreeing with me. You know, like, this is our best moment that we like, you know. This is the main event. Even Kayla knows this one. This is the main event. I see him. He's agreeing with me. So, which one do you want to do for us? Which one do you prefer? Singing or
let's give her a chance
<His
voice. laughs> So like not singing,
okay,
no. I won't sing. I'll just do a little poem
okay.
And not singing,
okay.
So I'll just do a little poem that I wrote yesterday.
Wow.
Like,
you came prepared.
No, like, I was all alone in my room, and then like, because I'm a person who don't like to be alone, I don't want to lie, but then yesterday I was all alone, so
yeah.
I just thought of some poems, some words, so that I can combine them and make my own poem.
Yeah,
so yeah. I'll do it.
Okay, the stage is yours.
The stage, okay.
Yeah, it's all yours. The mic, you can grab it if you like.
Okay, well, the title of the poem that I wrote is Loneliness.
Mm.
Well, sitting under a tree alone, feeling some wind blow, listening to bird songs, it feels calories. It's better than being with fake friends, with fake people. Hearing people bad mouthing, having fights all day long, is better being alone. Always crying. Always stressing yourself, always asking yourself question tags. It's better to be alone. Under the tree alone, brainstorming peacefully without any problems. It feels glorious. Well, poem by Diiva.
Wow. That's what's up. That's our PHB Diiva. Yes. Shout out to PHB Diiva. Shout out to Diiva. Yes. Yeah, you know, like we've reached, we're almost there at the end of our show. So I don't know, Lungzen, you have something to share? Oh, you're good. Eh?
Yeah, no.
All right, I can see. Okay. Diiva, do you have something to share with us, or to share with our listeners, or to share with your supporters before we could wrap this thing out?
Well, yes, I got something to say to the listeners and also my supporters, yeah. Mostly my supporters. Well, I can say I'd like to thank you all for taking this opportunity and listening to my show.
Yeah.
Well, my supporters, I would like to thank you all for supporting me from the start until today. Without supporters, yeah, I won't be here as a model. Because mostly modeling things need supporters. Without a supporter, you are not going anywhere with modeling.
Mm.
Even sports, even singing, but then without supporters, you are not going anywhere. Well, I can say my fans, I would like to thank you all. Especially my mom and dad. Ooh, those two guys were guys.
Shout out, Shem.
They are far from me, but then mom and dad, I love you, Shem. Yeah. Even my granny,
we're sending love.
I am sending biggest love, yeah, unconditionally.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
And well, I can say I'd love to thank my best friend.
Okay.
That male bestie of mine.
Yeah.
He's always there for me. Even though we fight, but then he's always there for me. Shout out to him.
Shout out to him.
I would say his name, but then he knows.
He's listening. Shout out to you, Anonymous.
Well, another person that I would love to thank is, I won't say the name, but then a special soul that is in my heart. Well, that person, I never thought he will support me all this journey, and I never thought that I would stand for the challenges that I face.
Yeah.
Mostly modelers, people don't get along with them because they thought they are doing something that is insecure. Well, it's not like that. But then the particular person has been there for my life, for my health, everything that I was facing. He was always there for me. Like, yo, I much love for him also. I won't say the name because, yo, I guys, you talk too much.
I will see what is going. What is going? I will see. We see you.
I understand. No, I won't say his name, and then I will say the stage name. Yeah. Shout out to Critical Scars.
Wow.
If you don't know, you don't know.
We'll go and say.
Don't do that.
We know him. Okay. Oh, yeah. Is that all?
Yeah, so it's all. I love you guys. Yeah. It was good having you in the show.
Yeah.
Even the presenters, yeah. Aisha, even though you are a little crazy, but then it was fun. Thank you guys.
I would just hope we didn't make you uncomfortable.
Yo, yeah. I feel like I can do a repeat show. Yeah. Yo, this is amazing.
We should have you next time.
Yeah, after July, she's gonna be something. Yeah. Gonna
and
have
this
again.
time after July.
Yeah.
I want cameras. Yo, I want to take a lot of pictures and post
we'll definitely
with you guys.
Do that.
Because I'll be wearing my crown as a queen and a sash. Wow,
yeah.
So that people they can see what they are. This is a real modeler.
Yeah.
Not a modeler that just talk, but
yeah,
then
take
deal
my
with
chances.
Pictures.
Can't wait, you know.
Yeah, yo. Yeah. Oh, guys. Oh, and it's something I forgot. Yo, yeah, I share, yeah. Guys. I'm sorry,
Shabu,
like,
yeah.
Because, like, I mean, that's my language, but
yeah,
then, yo.
Yeah, Zulu.
Yo, problem, guys, yo, yo, like, yo, I don't know why, that's why I don't like talking my language.
Sometimes it's a first day, good to see school.
I'm going to go to the school. Because, like, I went to Maning, they told themselves, like, Amazula ends and so on. So, well, for me, I Amazula Shem. In Kawayam, like, culture, I ain't feel it down in Ayo, Umakulumanga, but then, yes, I'm Zulu. Even all culture day, guys. Mabang bi ze futhi uinterview bazong interview ye camera ngizoxoxa izulu. Bona isukuthi I'm a proud Zulu.
Eh.
Ne. Obuye Natal enquthu. Yo, I'm sure ubaba mu proud ngabisha. Makaza lento le.
You're gonna definitely hear it.
Exactly. Yo, azoza indoni yakhe yamanzi.
Yo,
intom kuphela ngintom ngayise.
Definitely. Okay.
Na lo do agaw.
Aska bona for le na kumuzulu. Ngoba ngeke ngiyageke kuphule iselimi yawo.
Oh, kishaka Zulu.
Okay, guys, because of time, I ate the Makatelo and go for going karaoke. Okay, yes, our sister, thank you so much for allowing us to have you today to bless us with your presence. You know what? Just keep shining, Just run, no, don't look back. Just run. Just keep shining. Please promise us that you will keep shining.
I promise.
You promise, ne?
Well, obvious. That's an everyday promise.
Yeah.
You know, for me, I don't do empty promises.
You know, remain this beautiful. You know? keep shining.
Yo, I wish people can see you how ugly I am. Yo,
We feel blessed today.
Yes, that's why I say, like, we're blessed by your presence, you know. So, yes, just keep sharing everything that you said that you want to do, you know. Make sure that you achieve those things, you know, those goals. Because, like, after this year, after July, you know, we'd like to have you again, you know, to tell us about your journey.
dude and stuff.
So yes, thank you so much, né?
It's a pleasure.
okay, Magisiri. Yes,
we have reached to at the end of our show. Hi, listen, Chase.
Trust in love. I trust in love.
Tell hore diwa kai, follow me o tla utla mona
Zone 10 Radio FM.